One evening as the sun went down and the jungle fire was burning, down the track came a hobo hiking, and he said, "Boys, I'm not turning. I'm headed for a land that's far away, beside the crystal fountains. So come with me, we'll go and see the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, there's a land that's fair and bright, where the handouts grow on bushes, and you sleep out every night. Where the boxcars all are empty, and the sun shines every day. On the birds and the bees and the cigarette trees, the lemonade springs where the bluebird sings in the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, all the cops have wooden legs, and the bulldogs all have rubber teeth, and the hens lay soft-boiled eggs. The farmer's trees are full of fruit, and the barns are full of hay. Oh, I'm bound to go where there ain't no snow, where the rain don't fall, the wind don't blow, in the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, you never change your socks, and the little streams of alcohol come a-trickling down the rocks. The brakemen have to tip their hats, and the railroad bulls are blind. There's a lake of stew and a whiskey too. You can paddle all around them in a big canoe in the big rock candy mountains. In the big rock candy mountains, the jails are made of tin, and you can walk right out again as soon as you are in. There ain't no short-handled shovels, no axes, saws, or picks. I'm a-going to stay where you sleep all day, where they hung the Turk that invented work in the big rock candy mountains. I'll see you all this coming fall in the big rock candy mountains. I'll see you all this coming fall in the big rock candy mountains.
Hello and welcome to the special Saturday afternoon event of art and wonder. I am joined today by a very special guest, Kale. Kale, how are you, Kale?
I'm very good, Father. I mean, acquaintance.
Boy. How are you, boy?
Very good.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So, for those that aren't familiar, we've been making some videos together, the boy and I, and we wanted to share them with you. We've shared them with you off and on as they came out, but we wanted to take this time... Wow, that's getting really intense. Take this time to share all of them collectively with you in what we're calling Season 1, right? Season 1.
Phase 1, right?
Phase 1, yeah. If we're going Marvel?
Sure. I don't know.
So is it just like Marvel? Do they keep getting worse and worse as they go?
I don't know how to answer that.
Just answer it honestly, son.
No.
Well, today's episode is brought to you by some very special people. People like Abrogate Authoritarians, Michael Marks, Maxwell Meredith, Jennifer H., Brian, Kale, read a name or two as fast as you can.
Perry Nord. Break the...
Matthew Wallace.
Danielle.
Break the cycle. Or Bell. Level
Steve
zero.
Hartman.
Jack.
Anthony Mir.
John Odermatt. Mary Rome.
William L. Wells.
William Wells. If you would like to get your name on that list and have it read incorrectly someday, go on over to patreon.com/thesystemsdown and sign up for the Downers Club, where you'll get more weird, more raw, more offensive, more content whenever we feel like it. But today's bonus content is brought to you entirely free, because that's how much it's worth. Free.
Wait. Can
what?
My name be on the list?
If you pay. You gonna give me money?
I act for you.
You do.
I'll act like I'm paying.
And I'm going to buy you a shake.
Okay. That's good enough for me.
So, patreon.com/ the system is down. Support whatever this is and whatever nonsense we do in the future. It seems like our stream is a little lagging. Hopefully that gets itself worked out. let us know in the comments if you are watching and say hello, and we will watch some movies together. But yeah, if you have trouble hearing anything, any technical issues, please let us know. Otherwise, we're gonna go through some stuff. So let's just begin with the story, Kale. You and I decided to make some movies.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
You want to tell the story?
Sure. Once upon a time, there was a boy and his father. They set out to make a movie. And they did.
The end.
The end.
Yeah? How did all this start?
We're like, we should make some movies.
It's pretty much, yeah. Pretty much what's laid out in the movie. The movie is basically about how we started making movies.
Yeah.
But or how we do it every time.
Our movie was better than the boy and his father, the anonymous people that we don't know their names.
We're getting ahead of ourselves. We can't get too deep into the weeds because they haven't seen these movies yet.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. We're going to go through them. We're going to break down each one of them and give you all the behind-the-scenes stories. But overall, and it's been a rough, long season one at this, you know? It's been about a year or so.
Has it?
I don't know. I think it's been since last summer, so it's been close to a year. I think the first one, The Magic Trick, was at the end of last summer. And it started just because we wanted to make some movies and had some stupid ideas. And decided to do them. And the first one, The Magic Trick, was done in the very hot summer afternoon where do you remember anything about The Magic Trick that stands out on that hot summer afternoon?
Well,
any of the obstacles?
We're gonna cover that after we watch the video, right?
Who's running the show, boy?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, person that I don't know. Because you're not my dad.
Are we playing characters?
Yeah.
Okay. Who am I?
Jeff.
I'm Jeff. All right.
Wait. How about Gary?
Gary.
No, I want to be Gary.
Just arguing with yourself? Just take it away. You can just take over.
You
can just do all the characters. You host and you interview yourself, and we'll call it a day. The Magic Trick was on a hot day. That's what we have so far. And do you want to just watch it? Is that what you're going for here? You got. Okay. All right. This is the debut SMOTZ Shorts thing called The Magic Trick.
Hey, son.
Hello, father.
Would you like to see a magic trick?
We had to get back in the car in between lines. It was so hot.
You guys want to see a magic trick?
Thanks, son.
You forgot that.
Nope.
Ow.
So.
The first time I saw this video, I hadn't seen the SMOTZ Shorts thing. So I died laughing.
At that. It was just. In particular. Just the honk.
I was laughing at the entire thing. But mm-hmm. That stood out.
Yeah. Now, this one was. You had the trick, right? This started because you ran up to me and said, "We want to see a magic trick," right?
Yeah.
Tell the story.
So we got home from church one time. And it was shortly after I got home from camp, and my counselor showed me a magic trick, and it was the pencil thing, and so I just wanted to show him, and so we got home from church, and I was like, you want to see a magic trick? And he was like, sure.
Who's he? Are you talking to me? Are you talking to somebody else?
Joe over here.
Okay.
And
are you talking about when you told me those things?
Yeah.
Oh, so, okay, I'm right here.
Okay.
You can refer to me.
I told you.
Yeah, right.
Magic trick.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I showed you. And then that's. Then later.
Then there was more.
Some other time we were like, we should make a video. And then we were thinking about the video. And then we were like, what about the magic trick? And then
stuff, I think. I don't even remember that much.
Yes. Now, on the day of this, we were like, how do we do the bloody nose thing successfully? And it took a lot, and we were on a very large time limit, in addition to it being extremely hot out. And you can see, you can see fake blood on his arm there because we shot this last, and he already had the fake blood all over him, but you don't notice it until we point it out.
Yeah.
With the heat, like I said, we had to get back in the car about every 5 minutes because we were just dripping sweat, and you can see it in a few of the shots. Our hair gets more nasty as time goes on. But yeah.
That was terrible.
On the time crunch, we basically just had, it was just food color, right? We just had a little squirty bottle of food color.
So like I held the pencil and then I had like the other hand and it was like in the palm. Uh-huh. Like squeezed it with my palm. It was a process.
Yeah, it took like 3 takes, and the third one is the one that we ended up going with because you couldn't see the squirt enough. But by the third one, he was already covered in blood because it was food coloring. But we learned some lessons. We got a little bit of a squirt out of it.
And you can kind of even see it.
Yeah, you can see the bottle there if you look closely. You can see it behind the hand too, right when you hold it up.
But you don't notice it.
Yeah, you notice it when you're editing it though. It's fine. They've had enough time to marvel at the Hollywood magic and not notice these things, so we can point them out. Oh, and the crunching sound of the nose?
Oh, yeah.
That was a whole process.
That was like 5 different sounds.
Something like that, yeah. There was a squish, a crunch, like just to get it the right visceral amount of gross.
And it's only for a split second.
Uh-huh. Are you starting to understand what goes into this stuff?
Since the beginning.
Yeah, but like in this one and the first couple, when we would be editing it, you would be just really bored. And I've noticed that as time goes on, you get more, you learn more. And so you know what I'm doing. Instead of just sitting there being bored, you're having more input and making them funnier.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I know what you're saying, bro.
You're learning. You're learning, son.
No cap.
Oh, God. Yep. That is the magic trick. If y'all have any thoughts, feel free to drop them in the chats. And put fake super chat in the fake super chats. You cannot put real super chats because YouTube hates you and hates me and hates all of us. So use fake super chat in all caps if you want us to read your comments, for sure. Kate Paris says, fake super chat. My love and my little love. That is correct. That's right. Libertarians for our cases. This is amazing. So happy for you both. Yes, this is what some more libertarians need to do. Go make stuff with your kids instead of spending all your time running for some office that's going to cause nothing in life.
You're not
going to make it. You're not. Most likely. The boy knows more than most libertarians do. Kale, do you got any other thoughts on the magic trick, or anybody in the chat's got thoughts on the magic trick?
It sucked, but it was worth it.
It sucked in what way? Like, it wasn't done well?
No.
Well, it wasn't good, but it was worth it.
It was worth it, but it sucked to make. Not as much as some of the other ones, which we will get into later, right?
Yes.
The host of the show.
That's correct. That's correct. Co-host of the show.
Because it was so hot.
Yes.
It sucked.
We'll be getting to that one next, which, we went straight from in SMOTZ shorts, this idea of making these little short videos that we could make quickly and stuff. The second one, we decided to make a movie because that's what you do when you're making little shorts that won't take much time. And this one was a very painstaking one to do, which we'll get into some of the details on as we go. But Libertarians for RFK says, fake super chat. Have you seen video at The System is Down made promoting RFK? Shut up. Shut up. You don't get to free fake super chat, plug your own crap. No, not buying it. Don't vote for Kennedy. Libertarians, run away. Look into the Israel stuff. Just do it. What?
This isn't.
Okay. Anyway, see? That's what libertarians do. They poison the well. They make everything about themselves.
I know you do this for a living, but like we're doing this right now.
And what this is what I do, son.
Okay.
He wouldn't know. He's not allowed to watch my show. This is his first episode of the show.
This is not my first episode. I was doing a jelly bean game.
Yeah, that wasn't actually an episode, though. That was just a Facebook Live thing.
Oh. This is my first episode of the show.
Welcome to the show, son. All right, we are going to move on to the movie, which, as I said, is we just went straight from 40 seconds to 7 minutes, basically. How did this one come about, Kale?
Once upon a time, a boy and his father set out to make...
This one pretty much tells itself, so we'll watch a bit. We'll probably pause and talk about it as we go, because it's a longer one.
Oh,
so.
Yeah, this one really tells itself.
It does. It tells what you just said.
Once upon a time, a boy and his father set out to create their very own movie.
So you remember what I told you, the first rule is of filmmaking, right?
Show. Don't tell.
That's right. Show, don't tell.
Now, we can talk about all the little Easter eggs as we go. If you guys want to watch them completely unpaused and everything, go ahead and find them at smotzshorts.com. But yeah, this one we're definitely going to have to pause as we go through. Kale, you got any notes there?
Yeah, it took so many tries to get that shooting that thing out of my nose and over again. And, like, I was sweaty. I don't know. This has nothing really to do with anything, but I was sweaty.
And just a fun memory of my perspiration amounts. Now, on this one, it like this whole opening shot is one shot, so we had to get the entire thing up till the first break without any cuts. So if the bloody notes, which... For those that didn't catch it, he's got a bloody nose because the magic trick was the last one. Little Easter egg there. The bloody nose bit took... if we didn't get that just right, the rest of it was screwed up. So, yeah, getting all this in one go was something. And we're going to go back just to appreciate it.
Movie.
So you remember what I told you. The first rule is of filmmaking, right?
Show. Don't tell.
That's right. We show, don't tell. Do you remember why? Because if we over-explain things to the audience, and the audience thinks that we think that they're stupid, right? We don't want them to think that we think that they're stupid, because we don't think that they're stupid.
We don't.
So, we can do this, like the narrator idea.
You wouldn't laugh.
Yes. This opening shot took quite a few tries.
To keep that simple and not over-explain.
Explain the father to his son.
So what do we
stuff like
first?
That. We had to time out the pauses and everything, and had to have like signals for when to move on after the pause and all that stuff.
Characters?
That's right. You gotta keep that simple too, since it's just you and me. Like, it's just us. So who should our characters be?
A boy and his father.
I like it.
Here's the first
a
break.
A boy and his father.
Which was nice.
Now, we need a setting. So, a boy and his father, where?
In the woods.
Okay. Yeah, we could do the woods. We got the woods.
Like, this is literally the conversation that we have when we're making videos. Like, well, what do we need? Characters. Where? Well, we've got... You'll notice as we go through some of the videos that it starts out... Like in a hot summer, and then it goes to the woods in like the fall time, and then in the winter it turns into sock puppets, and then it's stop motion animation, stop motion. So like, they're all just based on what we can do around where we are, and some things shouldn't be done, even if we can do them.
And they end up good.
Yeah. So all the animated ones end up being in the winter time when we didn't want to go outside and freeze our butts off filming, because we suffered enough in the summer, which we're going to talk about in just a second.
And so the boy and his father worked together to craft a most epic tale.
Wait, if it's just us, who's going to hold the camera?
Well, we can use the tripod.
Oh, right.
Yeah, we can use the tripod.
And so the boy and his father.
I don't know. This.
You can say pause it out loud, and I'll pause it.
Okay. This is just kind of funny.
Share whatever.
When we were doing the every time I would say Might as well just go kill myself.
Yes, you got very, very dramatic with the yeah. You're not knowing about the tripod.
And I wanted to keep that in the video, but...
No, I drew a line there.
But you said...
You wanted to go much darker than I was... That was working. It would require more of a backstory if we found out that the boy was actually suicidal.
Yeah.
Doesn't really work in the context of the story, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, decided that wasn't going to work.
Yeah.
It's fine.
And
someday we should go through... Someday we should go through all the... Whatever, the thrown away stuff. All the B-roll and bloopers and outtakes and everything and share that, too.
Yeah.
If you guys want that, go join the... Or let us know if you want it, and then go join the Downers Club, because that's where it'll be first. What?
There's 44 people watching. That's like almost 100.
Wow. Good job, homeschooled kid. That's almost 97.
iPod worked together to craft and create the most epic tale of passion, journey, terror, and overcoming, discovering what it's like to be alone and afraid, staring into the eyes of your captain.
What? What? Stock footage.
Shot.
And you can't get past that anytime we watch this.
I can't.
Of all the suspended disbelief, you get attacked by a tripod later in this movie, but you just can't believe that light blue car is the same as a dark blue car.
That looks like a white car. I think it's just the reflection on it.
Well, it's blue enough, and it's the best stock footage I could find for the application of this very small transition.
Wait.
And I wasn't that worried about it to go out and buy a drone and film us driving down the road.
Are you cheating with the videos?
Define cheating.
Getting videos.
Whatever your definition, the answer is yes. All right.
Knowing not only that the hunter has now become the prey, but two, that it was not much...
Hey, I have to point out, I'm sure that nobody cared to actually listen to this random ChatGPT type babble here that I wrote into this, but if you listen to it, it is explaining everything that happens in the most dramatic fashion, and
it
so
really is.
It is the story that they wrote is the story that happens, but they're inside the story, and it's a whole cluster.
Eyes of your captor, knowing not only that the hunter has now become the prey, but two, that it was none but your own pride and carelessness that delivers you straight into the clutches of the scissor jaws of your own undoing. Superman was also brought up more times than you might think, but he was deemed outside the budget.
I think that deserves a mention as to why that's in there. Because Superman was literally mentioned way more times than you might think.
Yeah.
And there was no way to work Superman into this movie.
So every single time, he'd be like, now what next? I would be like, and then Superman comes in.
Yes. I'm there saying,
everybody.
Now we got to, like, what happens next in the story to keep simple things that we can do? And he's like, atomic bombs and nuclear waste and... Like demons, tornadoes, and stuff.
That wasn't me. That was Ava.
Either way, I mean, Superman isn't any more doable because then we have to get the licensing for Superman.
I think Superman is a little more doable than
No, because we would have to pay Warner Brothers to use Superman's likeness.
We could put like a backwards S on his suit.
That'll trick him. Throw him off. Superman. It's a Z with curves.
Yeah.
All right. Also, it should be noted that all of the audio here is fake. Every single bit of the audio except for us talking is fake. So every footstep in the woods, every click of the... Well, not some of the clicks of the camera are real, but 99% of all the audio while we're walking up the car doors and everything are fake. You weren't there for that painstaking process on this one, but you've seen the process in some of the other ones. Yeah. Any thoughts?
You weren't there when I made the stop motion video.
That's true, and we're going to get to that.
Okay.
And you will get all due credit, sir.
Okay. I'll give you all the editing credit, even though I've put some suggestions in the box.
That is true, and I will give you credit wherever it is due. So, yes. Watch and in pain.
Each footstep.
You got the tripod, right?
Oh, no.
Footsteps in the woods, too, which are not as easy to find.
Was it the same footstep every single time?
This spot looks pretty good.
Yeah.
I think it'll do.
Yeah. I would just set it up right here.
You can still hear the grass crackling and you're walking on
the see how it looks.
Shh. That's Hollywood magic, boy.
When I kicked that stick, I was like, I wonder if this is going to be in the movie.
Made the cut.
Yeah.
Good job.
And I was like,
whoa. Then you turned around and you're like, nailed it.
Then when I first saw the movie, I was like,
take a step back.
I remember doing that.
Yes. Fun camera trick here. That was, so I opened it up and then we had to take the there weren't actually two cameras there. So, well, there was one filming here. But then I had to take the one that's actually filming and move it up to the spot of the one that's going to be filming for the movie and then cut all of that together. It's just fun little things that, that you overlook.
I understand. But that didn't sound like it made sense.
Yeah, it probably didn't make sense to anybody but you and I, and that's fine.
I'm you, Dad.
You. Oh. Sorry. I don't think that's right.
Okay.
Take a step back. All right. Think it looks good. Ready?
Yeah.
See it.
Oh, I don't have the new one ready. I need to get that ready. Right. It was only in the title of the
before we even started.
We'll let him watch a bit without babbling too much. But you can talk over it.
Movie. Take one. Action.
Yeah, I told you to strut. That's what you came up with. And I, because I was walking next to you each time, I didn't know what you were doing. Exactly. And
yeah,
I did at one point have to tell you to walk, to not monkey walk with one foot and same arm.
Same yes. Legs.
Yes. That was your strut at first. So we at least got that down, but still got a little bit of the monkey swimming, yeah. I think.
Much better.
I've practiced my strut a lot since then.
Every day I get up at like 5 and it's strut. I don't do this anymore.
That's right. You work on that. It also took a whole lot of tries to get that strut and then the jump and scream and run down. It took a lot.
Yeah.
Do you want to explain the countdown?
Yes.
Go ahead.
It was every time before we started running and screaming, it was... 3, 2, 1
We would build up to the scream and then run. So this is us like placing the camera in a bunch of different places to make it look like the dad and his son are doing exactly what we're doing, which is trying to film a scary scene when they're only using a tripod. And so we had to run from a far distance in front of the camera to a far distance past the camera to get all the audio to work, right? Okay. Uh-huh. Yep, it is exactly as bad as it looks, and worse. You still haven't talked about the thing.
Oh, not the thing. How about we get to that once you see
it? Once you start scratching yourself?
Don't spoil anything.
Oh, sorry. We'll get there.
That was an awesome shot.
That was the longest one because we had to like start from completely off screen around the corner and run all the way down to it and keep going.
It was so tight.
Pants are real. And by pants, I mean panting, and the pants are also real.
No, they're fake pants. Maybe a little exaggerated. But...
exaggerated pants?
All right, let's check it.
He didn't actually say that. I didn't know that until just... like
a couple days ago.
2 days ago. Yes. I didn't know that he didn't actually say, "All right, let's check."
The "All right, let's check it" was taken from a different shot. I didn't say, I don't think I said anything there, but I copied that in. And also, your panting there is taken from something else too, and it just works perfectly.
Really?
No, maybe that one.
All right, let's check it.
No, there were several layers that were crossed over to get just the right stuff.
See, the stuff isn't even moving.
It's true. Hollywood magic.
These tripod shots.
I think this is about the time to tell the tale.
Okay. As you can see, I'm itching my pants.
Do not work, Dad.
I didn't know what it was then.
You are correct.
I am super itchy, and you thought it was poison ivy, but I told you that I can't get poison ivy. It doesn't.
I'm Superman.
Yeah.
Like, that's why I keep wanting to get him in these movies, because I want to reveal my true identity. Anyway.
That's. I didn't realize what you were talking about for a second.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Bugs.
Oh. So, after that shot, I think, was when we realized that it sucked too bad. We were going to go to the car and take a break, which was really far away.
It was very far away, yes.
And we had to carry all the stuff with itchy legs.
I think we left it the first time because we were like, we'll just cool off and dust our legs off. Because there was like sand and stuff, so we thought there was sand in our pants. Maybe that was making it itchy. And we were like, let's just go cool off, dust off. We'll leave some stuff here and come back. Because we did leave stuff because we had to go back after we found out the truth.
Yeah. So
the true nature of the sand.
The true nature of the sand. It looked like sand. There was enough sand. There was enough of it to be sand. It wasn't sand. It wouldn't brush off. It was tiny, tiny bugs that I don't know, they're called no-see-ums or something.
That's the unofficial, like, hillbilly term for it. I don't know what the official term is, but you can look them up. No-see-ums.
You can't see them.
You got to get real close. It's literally like a grain of sand, and then you realize that the grain of sand is moving, and you can't brush it off.
And you have to scratch each piece off. It sucked.
It did.
It was such a long drive home.
And that was the point. We didn't tell about leading up to this. Oh, we got to go back to the beginning.
We do.
Tell it.
The
mics?
Yeah.
Yeah, tell it.
I was like, I just thought of that when you said it.
Mm-hmm.
So we drove 30 minutes all the way out there. And
probably about 45.
Probably about 45.
It was 30 from where we were to the destination where we shot this. It was 45 back to our home, but go ahead.
It was probably like 30 from the place that we came.
You just repeat it, yes.
I'm not repeating you.
Okay.
So, yeah. So we got all the way out there. We started to get stuff out. And then I was like, we were walking down into the trail. And I was like, wait a second. Did we forget the mics? Just kind of joking. And we did.
It's the first time I have ever forgotten the mics, ever. And I had them charging in a different place than I usually would. And yeah, the one thing that he asked, did you remember the mics? No reason for him to ask that. And I was just like, oh no. And so we drove 45 minutes back home to get the mics. And then we drove 45 minutes back out here. So already this was like several hours later than we were planning on filming this.
Yeah. And also,
which will come into play later in the end.
Yeah. And also there was when we stopped back home, we were just trying to figure out anything else we might be needing. So
yes.
I picked up some bug spray, toilet paper.
Just in case. You never know.
Yeah. We got that DEET to try. Actually, no, that wasn't the first time.
Yeah.
Yeah. That has stuff. More to do with the bugs. The next time we had to go out there. Because of, we just needed to finish the movie and there was no other place to do it.
You're getting ahead of us now.
I'm sorry.
So with the no-see-ums, that happened. And when that happened, once we realized that they were bugs and we had to claw them off and take off our socks and shoes and pants to get them all off because they were crawling up our legs.
We left.
That was it for that day. It was like, no, we're good. Oh, actually, yeah, it doesn't come into play at the end because that didn't affect the end. The end we shot later. This was a 2-day shoot. It wasn't supposed to be.
Yeah.
And it shouldn't have been. But after the first time, we were like, no, we are done. And then we had to finish the movie.
Yeah.
So we had to go back into the pit of no-see-ums.
We were like, maybe they won't be there this time.
And we also wore like heavier socks and we sprayed the crap out of our ankles.
Yeah.
And just spoiler alert, it happened again exactly the same way. And
it did.
Not quite as bad, but still pretty bad.
Oh yeah, the first time when we got home, that shower sucked.
Yep. A lot of scratching.
A lot of scratching.
And
all over our legs.
They I feel like we're spending way too much time on bugs, but
no, that
whatever,
was
this is what people are here for. And yes, we earned the right to give the full story and make them sit through it because they are suffering way less than we did to give them this content.
Yeah.
So let's talk more about bugs. What's your favorite kind of bug?
No seal.
They're crafty little devils. But yeah, we did end up going back and we completed the movie, obviously.
Obviously.
We will show you where the cut is and it's coming up, I'm pretty sure, real soon because this is about the point that Kale was like ready to be hospitalized for his amount of itching.
Yes, my legs were terrible. I'm pretty sure after this scene was when we had to go back to the car to see what it was.
But more content toward the actual movie itself. Little Easter egg. The
oh, yeah.
The tripod is there watching us and judging us for our conversation.
This, just forget we said that. And
well, if you haven't seen it, we've completely ruined the whole thing by pausing it for 15 minutes to talk about it.
Yeah, well, never mind.
So go watch it and come back. But yes, the tripod is there watching us as we have this very rude conversation about him.
They do kind of suck, don't they? So what do we do?
Well, on the way here,
I was really suffering.
I was thinking.
I know. We had to get like three
maybe
takes.
Maybe you control the camera, and I could be the actor in this one.
Okay, but if we do that, I'm already in all the opening shots where we're running from the monster and stuff, and so it wouldn't make sense if I just disappear in the middle of it.
Good point.
It also doesn't make sense because who is filming this part? This is like the movie within the movie, and yeah, just. I don't know. It's fun because the tripod's there and it's zooming in. There's nobody there, but
that's crazy.
You're not to think about that because the audience is not stupid and we don't think that they're stupid.
Because they're not stupid.
Wait, I have an idea.
Back on course, the boy and his father.
So this was the return, right?
Yeah.
Or did we do this the first time?
We did not.
Okay, this was the return, and we also, you can see, we shot this in the opposite end of the trail, so we thought it might have been like we stepped on a hive of something gross, but it turns out they're everywhere, because we didn't, I don't think we did anything back on the main trail, did we?
I don't know.
I don't know.
We might have went back for a couple extra shots or something, I don't know.
Yeah. So, yeah, as the story goes,
we didn't go back.
I was happy to fall into this pit of razor sharp daggers and whatnot and kill myself because the no-see-ums came back.
Wait, do we still have the script for this?
I'm sure we do somewhere, yes.
Because there was a super funny line that got cut.
Which one? The baby.
Yeah. The baby draft of the batter.
What was it? Like, he's flailing around like a baby giraffe, like a slaughtered baby giraffe with a bad haircut or something like that.
Something like that.
Yeah. It didn't make the cut. It was too long, but
it was awesome, though.
Thank you.
I wrote the script.
All right. Here's the part where I die.
This is true.
Tread bravely into the unknown, not knowing what three-headed demons lie beyond that horizon. But wait, what's this? The father has fallen into a deep, dark pit with razor-sharp daggers at the bottom. Oh, it's awful. He's writhing in agony.
I had to put the sunglasses on top of my head to make them be able to fall off as I was falling.
Up everywhere.
I didn't really notice them very much.
Shut up. You noticed them.
I can't spare to show you. It's just
all this blood is real,
awful.
By the way.
It's just a bloody awful sight to see. Yet the boy bravely
this
pressed
was,
on complete.
It was a lot of food color that day, and we had to have like a team of 50 people just off screen squirting their hearts out, quite literally. All right.
Just.
Yep. Just squeezing.
I'm phased, brother.
That's it.
Some loss of his father.
There's no time to cry. I'm all we have left. I don't need anybody.
What?
They didn't get put in the credits.
the squeezers?
Yeah.
They never do. Here, because I'm holding the camera and we don't need the tripod in case you're too stupid. Sorry, I just like explaining the point. The camera switches to the camera being held by me and chasing him, following him, making the better action shots because he no longer needs the tripod, and the tripod, as you will find, is not happy about this.
I'm not wearing the sunglasses anymore.
Yeah, well, you know, we were in a hurry. We were in that daylight, and you had to run down this path, like, still 30 times.
Wait. Wait, did we go back in the other woods?
We might have for this part, yeah. That might be where we went wrong, actually.
Actually, I'm pretty sure they came
back. Yeah. Yeah, this is the same path, because we jumped over the stick. So we did go back to the same path.
Wait, we jumped over the stick again?
I think so. Yes, the shot from your perspective.
Yeah.
Which, for that shot, I just had you stand next to me and scream and run next to me while I shook the camera as though I was you. I like the breath. This part's back in the other spot because this is where we do the last scene. But
yeah, that's when it started getting dark.
Yeah, that's where we started running that daylight, and it worked out wonderfully.
It really did, because it just wouldn't have the same effect if it was light out.
It made us in a real big rush to get this done, and actually, the entire idea that we had to make the tripod move was fishing line.
Yeah,
which did not work at all.
at all.
So we changed on the fly to being more up close shots, which I think worked out better than it just gradually moving towards you. I think it ended much more dramatically, as we'll see. And this fall was not nearly as painful as it sounds. This was a fun shot. I had to make you lay on the ground for that shot, which I don't feel good about.
And
I'm
if
sorry.
You look really closely.
There's a towel.
There is a towel.
There's a towel there. Yeah.
Dad? Dad? Bud?
That is the movie. The longest one so far.
Didn't even realize the clapping for a second.
That's all bye.
How do you do that? How do you put in the clapping stuff?
I push this button. Yeah. I can also do this one. And this one.
Shut up, silly woman.
You never know when that'll come in handy, you know?
You never know.
Yeah, watch what you say. Now, that's the movie.
Shut up, silly woman.
That's the movie. You got any more thoughts on that? The two painful events and the many, many hours that went into it, and the editing on that one went pretty fast because we had all the shots nicely by the time we suffered through the shooting.
Yeah.
So it's a lot easier in the editing process to do that kind of do the live stuff than it is to do, you know, the stop motion or even the sock puppets and green screens and such.
Well, the sock puppets weren't as
green screens. You weren't there for that editing process. Still took a lot, but yeah.
Was it worse than? I'm gonna shut up now.
The new one. No, the new one is the most green screen editing that I've done for this stuff. So the movie.
Yeah. That one sucked.
It really did.
My stroke the heat was terrible. That's the one thing I'm stuck on there.
Yes. I think it was Danielle who said the sloth swim. Yes. That's what your strut was. The sloth swim.
Danielle.
Yep. Now, the next one. Are we ready to move on already? Did you have any more on that? We do have fake super chat from Christina Baxter. Says, fake super chat, the movie is my favorite. I'm going to assume she means her favorite of all movies.
Yes.
Thank you. That is very kind.
I'm glad I get to be an actor in your favorite movie.
Yes, that would make you her favorite actor of all time because I get killed off very quickly.
Yes.
Way too quickly for my skin pigment. But let's see. We have the
wait.
What?
What was I going to say?
I don't know. Did you have something more on that one? It was a long one.
Maybe I did. It was like really slowing down the podcast here.
It's all right. We can hold on. We have our ways. Just take your time.
Now I have to remember.
Now they're entertained.
Okay. Oh yeah, what does the super chat thing mean?
Well, a super chat, son, is on YouTube. Let me tell you a lesson, son. On YouTube, they allow you to set up your YouTube channel and monetize your YouTube channel, which means people can pay you to read their chats. Like, if they have a whole bunch of people in their chats, they can pay you to not only support your show, but also to get their chat read. So they can even promote their own stuff. They can do whatever they want. It's great. It's a great free market system. Unless YouTube hates you, which they do. They hate channels like mine because I talk about truth and knowledge and the future of society. Thank you, music, for playing along. But they do not allow me to take super chats, so I still want to hear what the people have to say, but I cannot read every chat, so I tell them to, in all caps, give a fake super chat, and I will try to get to it when I do, because I am nicer than YouTube. I love them more than YouTube does, because YouTube hates you. Thank you, YouTube, for hosting this show.
In all caps, fake super chat.
That's right. If you have a comment, put it in all caps, fake super chat, and we will try to read them, if we feel like it. But if you interrupt our show, we will not be kind to you.
We
so,
will hang you.
No, you can't say that on YouTube either.
Never mind.
Yeah, no. No.
We're
won't. We love you.
We love you.
We love you. And the government has never lied to you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wait a second. Start the next
one. All right, the next one is The Wrong Way. It took us a bit to put out another one. But we did have this idea since the beginning. And this idea, I should play the original, shouldn't I? Maybe I'll play it after. This idea comes from, actually, long, long ago, a friend of mine who was a co-host on the show in the past, Travis Harms, the Ginger Slate himself. He and I made a video that is this, where this idea came from. And we might have ripped a couple of the ideas off. But for the most part, this is a completely different one. So this is The Wrong Way, and we might play it and come back and talk about it, because I'm going to look for the old one while this one plays.
Yeah, this one's pretty short. We should just
it is pretty short. Okay, we can go back through, discuss each one. We don't need more music. Thank you.
The music.
Here's The Wrong Way. All right.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
Gross.
Gross.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's. There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's. There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
What do you call that, Kale?
Callbacks.
That's right. Callbacks.
Yeah.
Callbacks. I think we need a callback sound.
Whoa. I wish I had one of those.
Just to follow you around. Just a hype man.
Yeah.
All right. So we'll play the OG version after this, but what do you remember about this? Any thoughts?
I remember nothing. No.
I blacked out the entire time.
The time when we were like, we had to keep a straight face and take it out of
our
mouths. That really...
Let's go through each one, actually.
Okay, yeah.
This one...
it's hard not to laugh, but not the hardest not to laugh.
Yes.
We got to eat a lot of Reese's that day. It was great.
Yeah. Obviously, the sound effects are fake.
Yeah.
But to make it even grosser than they already were.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
That one's pretty self-explanatory. Now, this one, we had to figure out a way to have it... So I'm unchewing it and taking it out of my mouth and giving it to him where he puts it in his mouth and chews it up, and we're both gross about it. And you can, the cuts aren't that great. It could probably be better, but we put a lot into getting it as good as it is. So yeah, if you notice the cut, put a one in the chat. That'll really help our algorithm or whatever the Chinese tell us to do. A one. It's the number one. Did you catch it? There's a couple of them. You can actually see there's two of them right there. Your hand glitches.
It does.
Yep. And right here, my hand glitches a little bit. Because I had to do a cross cut of multiple types to get it even close. Because we're just we're not even monitoring the shot. We're just like, well, stand very still. Now chew it up. And now I'll pass you one and chew it up, and then we'll play yours in reverse. So we had to do the whole shot, basically, of us both chewing it without moving as much as possible.
And the way my face looks, the reason my face looks like a frog is because that's what I had to do to not laugh. So go back a little bit.
Let's point out how dumb I look.
Go back to when you're chewing.
It's very clear that you're trying not to laugh. Yes.
No, go back to when you're chewing.
Oh.
Yeah. Look at my face. It looks like a frog.
It looks more like you're trying not to laugh when you're chewing.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
And that, we were just trying to figure out what to put there.
Oh, so yeah.
He just put one in his mouth and chewed it up a bunch, and then he was like, wait a second.
Yes, the camera was still sitting there filming the thing from another shot, and I was like, well, we need a transition for that one, because we decided at the end to do we were just going to play like the vintage No Wrong Way thing. We decided to do our own. At the very end, we were still filming from the last one where the water dumps on it or something. I don't know. The smashing one, probably. And then I put one in my mouth that he just smashed, and we were thinking, then I just hit record and spit it out onto the counter because it seemed like the most fitting one for the chewed up and shared.
Wrong way to eat a Reese's.
And then I licked it up off the counter.
To eat a Reese's.
Yeah, he did.
Not really. All right.
You didn't.
I did not. This one,
Oh, yeah.
This one took a few tries to get it to stick, mostly.
The way
Do you remember?
Was
I had to smack myself at least three times without it sticking before we actually got it to stick.
The way we got it to stick was he licked the top of it.
A lot.
Made it moist.
A lot.
And then he hot on it.
Uh-huh. And then I handed it back to you, and then you handed it back to me.
And then he...
And then I prayed. And here's what happened. You can even see the chocolate on my hand.
Yeah. And he had to hold it there for a second.
I did.
There's no wrong way.
And with that, we just put the Reese's on a glass plate, put another glass plate on top of it, and push it down real hard. And
yep.
Then, yeah. So I'd say
yep.
that. Never mind.
We got one. I don't remember what it was for, but we got one. What was it for?
We got one.
I told him to put ones in the chat for something.
Oh.
And then I distracted myself.
It was... Oh, if you see the cut.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Who cares? All right. For this one is a throwback. We did this one in the original, as you will see. How'd this go for you, Kale?
So, I had to stick my head in the toilet.
It was a clean toilet.
With, like, you know, my swoop here and everything. It kind of hung down
in a little
the
bit.
Toilet. And I had to put my face real close to the water. And my hair goes about 3 inches away from my face.
Yeah. So not my proudest moment as a father, but he's fine.
And he got this big thing of water and dumped it over my head in the toilet so that it would look like my head was in the toilet. And then I had to have a big smile on my face when I whipped it up. And
yes, you had to be waterboarded a couple times, which is torture, where they pour water on you. Yeah, you had to have that done to you at least three times.
On YouTube.
You had to have water poured on you in a trickle, like a sprinkle for a baptism of Catholic proportions.
Yeah.
That's what I meant.
Sure. It was a big, like, one of those big things that, I don't know, we use it for potatoes.
Yeah.
When we
a pot.
Boil them.
It's called a pot.
It was a big black pot. Has all these white specks.
It's just a pot.
Sure.
Nothing special.
It was really
a pot.
Big, though. That's the point.
It was a big pot.
That's
big
what
old pot.
At.
You can tell by the speckles. Now, with this, there's even the sound effects for the blooping and stuff. We spent a lot of time getting just the right bloop for a tiny object falling into a shallow basin of water that sounds like a toilet. And enjoy.
I had to kind of whip my head in there.
Yep.
I'm so happy. I caught it. I caught something, Dad.
Yep. It's a fun one. You can see all the other attempts all over the floor there. And you can also see the tripod off to the side. So, or no,
oh,
that's,
I've
that
never
would be
even
the light the light stand, actually, because I'm holding the camera.
Yeah, never mind.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
And that worked out surprisingly well.
It did.
It pushed the other one out of the way just so it could go right in the same spot.
Yep.
Was that even on purpose?
Nope. Not even a little bit.
Whoa.
And then you've got the tripod callbacks at the end.
Yeah. I was making a stupid face the whole time. Moment.
You can also see that you're sitting at the same table that the movie was shot at.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Callbacks. Wait. Look.
There's more.
In the Wait, Picasso what? Painting.
Oh, no.
Go back.
Oh, no. I lost it. That's not it. That's not it. That's it.
Go to the end. Go to the end. The Picasso painting, you can see. You can see the light.
Oh, snap. You can also see them in the reflection of probably in the glass behind us here. It's okay. Nobody notices until you point it out. Oh, I guess you can't in this angle.
Yeah.
Can a little bit here. No, that's I don't know what's happening. Who cares? Anyway, the next one. So at this point, we were getting into the winter, and you were working on stuff on your own.
I didn't think it was gonna be like anything. So
you didn't believe in yourself.
And like, it wasn't gonna be as long as it was until I was like.
Until I was like, it should be longer.
Until I was like. It should be long. So, yeah. So, I was just in there, my room,
mm-hmm.
one frame at a time.
Tell us about the process. Well, let them know how much you put into this. I've been there. I've done stop motion. There's a reason why I don't do it anymore. Tell them why I don't do it anymore.
Because it really sucks. But it can also be fun, like, because you, like, it's like you're making, like, one of those Hollywood movies. You have all those different sets.
Mm-hmm.
So you just, like, a lot of the walls aren't even attached to any of the buildings or anything. It's just the perspective of the camera. And.
Yeah. I like it. Keep going.
And so.
Nerd it up. That's what we're here for.
Yeah. And, it's.
You mean in some shots, there's backgrounds that don't even have walls. You're just zoomed in so you could get the different angle and figuring out those different techniques that you have to do to be a filmmaker.
And there are certain things that are in the video that aren't supposed to be in there that I realized...
Now they're Easter eggs.
...fairly quickly. Well, there is actually a couple Easter eggs in there that refer back to things I've made in the past that were that kind of sucky. But, yeah. So...
Like what? Do you want to talk about them or wait till they see them?
I'll wait till
or do you want to even point them out or let them find them themselves? They probably won't because people are lazy. If they've made it this far into the episode, it'll be a miracle.
Yeah. Oh, like 45 people have, unless they've like switched out a couple times.
Who knows?
Nobody knows.
Who knows? All right. So anything else?
Still here.
And any pre-talk on this is the Halloween one, which you... Was it supposed to be? It was supposed to be a Halloween one from the beginning, right?
It was. Actually, I think for this one, it was supposed to be SMOTZ Shorts the whole time because I was like, I want to make a Halloween SMOTZ Shorts stop motion.
Yeah.
And then I did. And then I was going to make one for Christmas too, but it was just so close in between. It takes weeks to make these things. And
we should play. I would play the park. I've showed you the Parks and Rec clip of the stop motion thing. Where he's like, I compared it to Avatar.
Oh, yeah.
I spent 3 months of my life on that. And it's like 20 seconds long, tops.
He wakes up, gets out of bed.
Yeah, that's literally how it is.
It is.
And I know because when you were in the hospital being born, I made a stop motion animation video randomly, which I can't find. But it's strange that you've gotten into the same thing.
Wait, Joe, why were you at my birth?
I was hosting. Kate Paris says, fake super chat, Kale, you are amazing at stop motion. It's so much fun to watch you watch your process. I'm so proud of you.
Aw, you. You.
Oh, before we play that one, I forgot we have to play this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. This was just messing around back in the day. I was young. I was like a little bit older than Kale.
Wait, why is there the computer around it?
Because this is a screen share now. Oh. So they're watching on the internets. This is an old one that you probably have not seen, but a fun throwback to where this idea for The Wrong Way came from. Crappy cameras. It's fine. There it is.
I like my Reese's moist.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
Oh, yeah. You should do a smash.
I like my Reese's flat and dirty.
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
It was not clean, no. It was flat and it was dirty. Nothing about that was sanitary. Locusts were so loud.
Oh, motherfucker!
There's no wrong way to eat a...
He said, I like my Reese's packaged. And you could see him trying not to laugh at the end of it.
I like my Reese's
packaged. Oh, motherfucker!
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
Apparently this was the year of the locust.
I've only seen this like this.
Yeah.
I like my Reese's. Wild!
There's no wrong way to eat a Reese's.
How much is left?
Oh, yeah, we did outtakes back then.
This is Travis Harms.
Okay, what? Why did you jump in? What?
Yeah, So I was young once and also didn't know how much to include or not to include, so there's no reason for all this to be here. I think we're going to move along. That's like double the movie, and we have more of our movies to get to, so.
Yeah. Yeah, totally.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Any thoughts? Any thoughts on that masterpiece?
I never have. Any thoughts?
Oh, that's a shame. Yeah. You should try.
No.
Okay. Now we were on to the Halloween one. The Halloween one, you did all the visual stuff from the beginning and said, here, I have this. And I said, do you want to do voices on it? And you said, yes. And then...
Actually.
Okay, go ahead.
Actually.
Actually.
I was like, no, I feel like this wouldn't be as good with voices because, like, their mouths don't move and, like...
Oh, yeah, I talked you into it.
Yeah, but...
Do you think it's better or worse?
I think it's far better than it would be without voices.
You're learning. The more obsessing that you do, the better it will be. At some point, you have to stop obsessing and let it be what it is, but yes, it can always be better.
Yeah, and... Yeah, I was part of the editing process.
You were a lot on this one.
It was.
I had to wake you up a couple times, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah. I was doing everything.
Anything else on your masterpiece?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Are you ready?
At the beginning of it, when it says KL Gamer Presents.
Uh-huh.
So that's just some stupid, cheesy name I made up. Like, a couple years ago.
I have my same shames from childhood. It's fine.
It was like 3 years ago.
I had a Zanga page once.
I still use that name on stuff just because it's just what I've always used.
Mm-hmm.
Even no matter how cheesy it is, I still use it. And, yeah, that was actually... So, on, like, it's Scratch a thing.
Coding and stuff?
Yeah, coding. That was from a game I started making.
Yeah.
I never finished it, though. But I just screen recorded
You made a lot of other games, though.
What?
You made a lot of other games. Would you like to promote them?
Totally, yeah.
Go ahead.
So there's...
Just tell people where they can find them.
There's Happy Box. There's Blank Ball. Oh, yeah, there's Duck Crash.
Duck Crack, huh?
Duck Crash.
Oh, Crash.
That was my very first one.
Mm-hmm. Classics.
3 years ago. Mm-hmm. So I didn't know what I was doing at all. Now I'm a pro.
Right.
Yeah. It was literally a picture of... a picture that was already, like, pre-made on Scratch. It was, like, a background and of, like, a alleyway, I think. And then there was a car... that crashed into something, and there was a duck in it. And then when he pressed space, the duck would say, "Ouch!" Like, literally just like that, but a little squeak here.
Like, ouch?
Yeah, totally. And,
So where can people find you, Kale?
What?
Where can people find you?
You can find me at scratch.nyt.edu. Kale Gamer. Capital K, capital L, Gamer.
Very nice.
And also, one more thing. I'm really slowing this podcast down. So, Dad.
What?
Don't fall asleep.
Did you have one more thing?
Maybe.
Before I push play on Halloween, just one.
Push play, it doesn't matter.
It does matter.
Thank you.
But if you would like to move on,
okay.
While you think, we can do that. Would you like to do that?
Never mind. I don't really have anything else. So
just don't ask me any more questions. Just leave me alone.
I'm just kidding.
Just let me just play the movies. Gets up and walks out like Kanye. So the Halloween one, yes, you did your thing, and then you brought it to me, and we did a lot of the audio together, and here's. That.
Trick-or-treat!
What's up, right?
Everybody moves at the exact same time.
Uh-huh. Having a whole street of people moving?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Because during Halloween, everybody's out.
That's right.
And, like...
You gotta do what you gotta do. Get that opening shot.
I have a couple of videos that don't have voices. They have sound effects that I put in with what I could do. And they the sound effects suck, but the videos are still good. And
yeah,
they're not SMOTZ shorts, but maybe they could be. Remember?
Have your people contact my people. We'll talk.
Who are your people? What are their emails?
It's me. Dan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
The Halloween one.
Trick or treat!
What? Who's that? Oh, hello, children. Would you like some candy? I've got candy right this
Ooh,
way.
Oh, yeah, candy, yeah.
Yes.
Go on.
That's a bad idea.
No, don't be such a shrimpy nerd.
My mom told us not to, but what a man.
Any thoughts?
Do your voice.
Which one?
Do the voice.
Oh, hello, children. Would you like some candy? Candy, candy, candy.
Do your Harry Potter.
Well, Mom told us not to, but what do I know?
I'm the mustache costume guy. I did that voice by just breathing in while I'm talking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, candy.
Perfect. I've got your candy right here, boys.
Candy.
Here's
no,
candy.
Candy.
Oh, candy. Candy, candy, candy.
Ron.
Ron.
There is an Easter egg Ron in there from Harry Potter, if you listen closely.
Really closely, you hear me saying,
Ron.
That's not candy. Ron. It kind of sounds like run, but it's Ron. Either one works.
Yeah. I like it.
It's not candy.
Candy.
Oh, Ron. Candy.
Ron.
Candy, candy, candy.
One more Ron.
Go back more. Notice how their arms are gone because they couldn't fit in the two spots.
I don't think I've even noticed that.
Really?
Yeah.
It's kind of like that. It's kind of like their arms are tied up.
It works.
It kind of works.
Yeah. Yeah, I've never even noticed that they didn't have arms.
And also notice the hole in the wall. That's where the flashlight was for the light.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Yeah. Candy! Candy, candy, candy. Candy.
When they were coming back to life, that sucked. Making every single little piece move and come back together slowly.
All at the same time.
All at the same time.
Yep.
Stop! No!
Oh, yeah. That wasn't the same wall. Sorry. I just have a lot of commentary on this video.
It took a lot, you guys.
Notice how...
This is what he was talking about.
...how big the wall is compared to
you
how...
You could never get a camera in there.
Yeah, that's not the same wall. I just built a new wall and put the window in there, and it works because
Hollywood magic.
Now on the outside, it was the same building. But
yes.
Let's continue.
Stop! No! No! Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Wait, stop! I'm sorry.
We got up to the same point that we stopped last time. Go ahead.
Go back a second. A second.
A second.
Okay. No. Can you move our little people?
What?
Can you move our little people?
Oh, are we in the way?
Yeah. Look at that little guy in the back.
Oh, Easter egg cop guy.
Yeah. That's the thing. That's the thing that I made a long time ago that was supposed to be in there. It's, okay, so.
Just say it.
Shortly after I watched Fantastic Mr. Fox.
He was young, you guys.
I was thinking, I want to make a stop motion video. And all I had back then was a little Android phone where I could only pause the video to move it. I moved it 80 frames at a time. I kind of want to watch them. I don't know how.
Anyway.
Okay, yeah, never mind.
Getting a little in the weeds here.
Yeah. So, yeah.
So his name was?
His name was Fantastic Mr. Cop.
I was waiting for this.
And yeah,
he's there sometimes.
He's there.
You might see him again if you look closely enough. All right, let's finish this.
Okay. Not really. But you can keep going.
How did you stab him? Go ahead.
Oh, I wasn't even thinking about that. But the way I stabbed him was I just got some sticky tack. I tried to color it red, but you can't really tell. I just stuck the sword in
there. Yeah, it's just blue blood.
There's also sticky tack on his back so I can stick to the wall.
Yeah.
And that part that he's sticking on is actually a bridge.
Nice.
Because he's not actually inside. the house, because that's not how that works.
Oh.
That's actually a Lego bridge that I built, and yeah.
Is it the same bridge we're going to see later? Shh. No spoilers!
Well, 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 what do we have down here?
We laughed a lot. We laughed a lot here.
Yes, we did. Go back a little.
Well, 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 what do we have down here?
Go into it, just the tiniest bit, into the next part. You can still see him hanging on the wall over
and the bridge.
In the corner, on the bridge.
Nice.
It's
the same universe.
Yeah.
Whoa.
You don't notice it unless...
Unless you do.
Unless you do.
Yeah.
Kill these boys! I'm gonna find them and I'm gonna kill them right now. I'm gonna kill them! Oh, no. I'm in half. I'm halved. Oh...
I seem to remember you being skeptical on the voice here.
Yeah, not the voice, just what he's saying. Like, when they have the smile, they're not able to talk. They're just mindless zombies.
I'm in half. I'm halved.
I like this better.
I'm in half. I'm halved. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, this is it. Who's this guy now?
Reproduce.
Oh, he's getting...
under the bridge.
That there's action.
Yeah, there's action. There's the cat.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's the cat on the podcast too.
Yeah, I know. I don't watch your podcast.
All right. Anything else on that one, Kale?
Did everything, and thank you for the applause.
I see how it is. He did next to nothing on some of these. I should probably point those out as we come to them.
Yeah, I suppose that's true.
It's only fair.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I feel like I'm going to miss something, and then later...
Was the one that had like a whole lot of sound effects, and you saw more of that process. Do you remember anything that was worth noting?
No.
Okay.
But I know later when I'm in bed, I'm just going to like, oh, wait, I should have said that.
Happens every time. Every time. As soon as you stop recording, you remember all the things you meant to say.
And then you just turn it back on. Wait, come back.
One more thing.
Yeah. Wait, don't leave yet.
Yeah, the stream will end, so we won't be able to do that, but we will continue. What is next? Next is the Christmas socks, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Let's play that. Do you have any thoughts on this one before getting into it?
It was really cramped under that table.
It was. We were like, well, we want to do another video. We don't have a lot of options being stuck indoors during the winter. Stop motion is taking a long time, and his next one he was working on, we wanted to do something easy in the in-between, and so we were like, what about sock puppets? That'll be something easy. And it was easier than most things we've done. It was easier than stop motion and easier than all the live ones that we've done.
I think it was probably the easiest we've
done. Definitely the... Yeah, probably the easiest of all of them, even. Yeah, except for maybe last night's. The new one that's still in the works.
Yeah, you don't know about that one.
You don't. Shh. But yeah, the Christmas socks one was just a matter of one setting with one green screen and a lot of aftermath editing. But we knew that we needed sock puppets. And so the night of, we decided to go out and find the supplies for sock puppets. At Dollar General. And we found socks. And baby socks.
Socks that we accidentally stole.
We did not steal them. They did not take the little beeper thing off of it, so I had to run back. There's always some sort of adventure that before we actually get into it.
It was a 45-minute drive back to Dollar General.
It was not. It was about a 3-minute drive. But, yes, we got those, and then we could not find googly eyes there, so we did not want to... We could have just drawn them on.
We could have.
But we decided... I found these little clear capsule things, and we found, what were they?
I got, I
we were trying to find like a candy that would work, like Whoppers or something.
Yes, something ridiculous to make it rattle.
And then I found the sweet tarts, the sweet tart ball things, and like the purple ones were the ones that
yes.
we ended up using because they were the darkest.
Yep.
Looked more like an eye, I guess.
Yes. This is the Christmas socks.
Papa! I look so retarded.
What's a Christmas bonus?
Can't say that word.
I can't.
Not
well, son, that's something from a different time and a different economy. Long, long ago.
Oh.
It's been a rough year, son.
That's better.
But I still want to get you something nice for Christmas.
Oh, Father. Our adventures here there have been all the gift I need.
I know, son. I've enjoyed them too, but I've got a little extra something set aside to make Christmas extra special.
Notice how the ground doesn't move when we walk.
Mm-hmm.
Well.
It took a lot.
I really don't need much, Father.
In front of and also behind them?
Whoa. Maybe a kerchief, or just a new blanket to keep me warm at night, or even a new pair of socks would be ducky.
Ducky.
Socks?
That wasn't real rally.
It wasn't real gunshots either.
Merry Christmas, Father.
Merry Christmas.
I'm telling what happened. Maybe there were just some kids running
around. Merry
and he fired a gun to scare the kids and then grabbed them.
Yeah.
Whatever
Maybe
you put on
his kids.
Whatever else you put into that is that, on you.
That's your own fault.
That's right.
Christmas.
Yeah! Yeah!
The giggle was left on purpose. And Kate didn't help with this one. She was the baby socks.
And sing! Good job, everyone!
I've always loved how the socks
were. Why don't the socks grab it? He's eating my face.
And that was the green screen, if you didn't notice.
Yes.
It was right there.
Yeah, they were on the set. You said quiet on the set and turned back to the studio. Yeah.
Ken.
What?
Ken.
Ken? Oh, yes. Yeah, there's a lot of outtakes on this one. At one point, they were yelling at Ken for what reason?
That wasn't on
Offset?
That was on the...
Oh, yeah, that was on... they all run together. All right. Any other thoughts on the Christmas socks? We did add the rattles back in for the eyes in certain spots, which was fun, and... obviously, all the background is fake. And
those are fake.
Taping the hat to the head and the eyes to the front and drawing a mouth on a pair of socks is not nearly as easy as you might think.
Also,
which is why Kales is mentally special.
My eyes kept falling off.
That's true. This one was easier than most of ours, but for all of the challenges we had in the last one, we never had any of your eyes fall off. So, you know, it's better in that way. What now?
So, like, the super glue kept just coming off when I, like, bent the sock at all. It sucked.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It did. All right. That was the Christmas special. Which... I felt like harkened back to the old claymation animation Christmas specials of old. So it seemed like a good time to... We had the Halloween special, now we have the Christmas special. And then we did... you did one more in this first round, this first season, this first phase of SMOTZ Shorts.
Ooh, yeah.
Tell us about the next one, Kale. Aptly titled, the next one.
Okay. So... This one is actually longer than the first one by just like 10 seconds maybe, but it's more than twice as many frames because...
The season really ends on a dark note.
Yeah. This one is 24 frames per second. The first one was only 12 frames per second.
Doubling up.
So...
It means twice the pictures.
You have to explain this to a lot of people.
Yeah.
Because they don't understand. It's the...
Twice as much work.
The frames go a lot faster than the first one. So it looks smoother and stuff, but it's still longer than the first one. So this one took a lot more weeks and a lot of days.
Yes.
And yeah, it was really fun.
In this one, the same as the last one, I don't know if we mentioned, there's no plan for words or anything. The words are all figured out as we go. We make it up together. And
We figured it out.
It got a little more disturbing after we figured it out, but we figured it out. What was your thought process while making this one?
I want to make a Star Wars video. Also, when I first started it, I thought it was going to be like another stupid one. So the Halloween
just a throwaway thing for fun,
on purpose for Smotz shorts. But then this one, I really didn't have any plan. I wasn't going to make it Lego at all.
Yeah.
Like, in the beginning, if you haven't seen this, I'm spoiling it. But when the hand walks in, that was terrible. Just me moving my hand super slow while pressing the button.
You're like, at least with Legos, I don't get hand cramps.
Yeah. I was planning on not using any Legos because those suck to walk. And that's... Yeah.
If you're not wearing yours, I'm not wearing mine.
Sorry, it's hard to, I can't wear it with the headphones.
Lame.
You look so much better with yours, though.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So, anyway.
Anything?
Yeah, so after I got, like, the...
Started with not Legos, you switched to Play-Doh, like, the putty, and then you switched to Legos.
So I got the walking, and then the thing, and then it went down, and... skeleton, and then the other Lego dude came up, and then then that's when I showed him on my phone the video, and he was like, and I was like, this one is just for fun, it's not even gonna be for Smotz shorts. And you were like, are you sure? It could be. And I was like,
dun dun dun, challenge accepted. And then...
So, then I had to keep going and add Legos and...
I had to bust my butt to make it worthy.
Yeah, pretty much.
You put a lot into it after that.
I did. I mean, the first part's that, but put a lot...
You want to just play it? Talk through it?
Sure, yeah.
All right. If you want, I guess. This is the next one. What's the title of it?
The next one. Yeah, this was before it was even meant to be Smotz shorts.
Yeah. And I like this
one. Well, I'm alive. Hey, am I alone here? Do I have a friend?
Character as my hand went up, and it was really hard to get my hand to the exact same spot after I moved it to put the other piece on.
Yeah.
So
you just do the feet and the torso and the head?
Yeah.
Let's go back and watch that again.
So as you can kind of see that my hand is kind of cupped.
Well, I'm alive.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, am I alone here? Do I have a friend? Are you my friend?
No.
Yeah?
Wait, go back to the very beginning. I'm sorry. It's just, there's a lot of things.
Very beginning?
Yeah. No, not... Okay, start it. With that part, that was terrible to make. Because like I would have to get a strip.
It takes even longer to make it, so deal with it.
I'd get a strip of the sticky tack and like put it partway under my finger, and then take a couple frames until it's already all the way through. And I have to get another one and try and lift my finger up.
Yeah.
Do it again.
Keep your hand in the same spot.
And then you can see it's kind of detached at the very end there.
Yeah.
That's what that was. That part was just fun.
It was hard
to do it with my hand, though, and make it not move my hand at all.
Yeah. Now, in this, we did the voices and then added, we like pitch shifted them to make them more fun.
Hey, am I alone here? Do I have a friend? Are you my friend?
No.
Yeah?
No. Yeah, I don't know this guy.
You are?
Shut up. No.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah.
Yeah?
No.
Yeah?
No.
Yeah?
No.
Yeah?
Yes.
Wait, that by itself is like stuck.
No, no! No.
Yep.
Yeah.
And that food coloring didn't actually splash.
It did not.
All it was is putting it on it. It just has
you didn't actually
like
explode it. A Lego zombie and have it explode out orange.
It actually, I mean, it was the. It didn't actually like. It just.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it kind of makes it seem like it.
It does. Like, does seem like it.
Never mind. And also, notice how there's orange on his face. That's uh-huh. because. That was a different day that I had to do that. And I do this all day, so just up to this is like...
Probably 3 years?
Probably doing it 2 days up to this.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe more. I don't know.
Then you gotta cut and come back to the no-see-ums or whatever struggle you have at this point.
Oh, yeah. And, like, this was, like, around New Year's when I was doing this part.
Uh-huh.
I think it was stopped on that frame, even. And, like, oh, people went in my room.
Yep.
That thing was in my
it's
room.
It's a very delicate process.
It is. I said, I don't really care.
I said,
you touch.
I don't know you anymore. I wish you were dead.
I said, I get out of really my room. Care what you touch. Just don't touch this at all. And
of
guess
anything,
what they
not
touch.
That. First thing.
The first thing they touched.
Yep.
So they moved the skeleton guy. And then they moved the...
We're going a little long. And we got to get to the new one.
Okay. Okay.
So let's keep moving a little bit.
I feel really passionate about this.
I understand that. And you should.
And this
because
part
it took a lot.
Because like by now you're just trying to do... like. You want it to be good, but you're still trying to do like the bare minimum. Because it,
like Disney.
You just want it to get done by now.
Yep.
So, yeah. There's the fishing guy. I don't know if you can really tell that's a fishing pole, but...
The very happy,
like
happy man.
There's a little blue piece of sticky tack at the end of the string, so that's like a fish or something.
Uh-huh. Also, we didn't even note the music.
Oh, yeah.
Goes, it's happy. Beginning, then it goes to dark, and then it goes to happy here again, right after the very sad part. Just straight to do 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 do. Ow! Yes.
Oh yes. Oh hello, young man. What is your name?
Now tell about the water.
Oh, yeah.
How'd you do the water?
Also, go back to him falling. Just a little bit. No, when he first goes into falling. Stop. Go. And stop really quickly. Okay, notice all the clear pieces that you don't notice. Uh-huh. Notice the sticky tack that's also holding him onto it.
Yes.
It just goes so fast that you don't yep. even notice.
So that's a clear pole with sticky tack holding him out for that one frame.
Yeah. Nice. And you had to do that for every frame.
Nice.
And also, yeah, with the water, the hat falls in first, and that's a splash. And then he falls in with another splash.
Uh-huh.
That's every single water piece building up and then falling
every,
back down.
Every drop of Lego.
Yeah.
Who's that?
And it's just for that split second.
Yep.
And then he jumps in the water, too. I mean, the water shots weren't even the worst part of this.
You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. I saw his pole there, too, that he slides down.
Yeah.
I mean,
I've never seen that, and I worked on that.
Yeah. Also, there's the Fantastic Mr. Cop head.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Down in the water?
Yeah, down
there. There it is. Down there. Next to the leg.
Yeah.
Now, this point, I think this is copyrighted material?
No, it's not. I mean, everybody has used this.
I haven't.
Like every...
Actually, I did on this.
Yeah. I mean, every single show...
This was the one line of dialogue that you had. like, that you wanted in the movie when you were done with it? There was nothing else planned as far as voices, but you were like, he's saying, you don't have to be bad, you can be good.
Yeah. This was the only part in either of them where anybody's mouth actually moves.
Mm-hmm.
Because he has the other face on his head, on the other side, and so it was open and closed and open and closed.
Yes.
Over and over again. And yep. Yeah, so just watch it.
Here's the result.
You know what I mean?
You don't have to be bad. You can be good. You can be...
And then it switches back to the happy music for some reason. For no reason. What?
Watch him walking over to the kid.
Who?
The skeleton. Dude.
Before this?
Yeah.
Just... Four. You know what I mean?
Also, just like each movement of each limb.
It's a lot.
It is.
They'll never get it, no matter how much you tell them.
Probably like 50 frames is making them walk over there.
It's ridiculous.
Because this whole thing was... I have to check. I'm sorry.
A lot. It's a lot of frames.
Yeah.
And then... goes back to the happy music.
Here we are. Okay.
Because we thought it'd be funny.
It was 1,555 frames.
Which means 1,555 pictures taken on your phone.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And look at this. I don't know if I'm scrolling back or not.
You're not. Look. It's just action.
No.
It's a lot.
Wait, no, that.
It's a lot. Yeah. It is a lot. That is a lot. Yeah. That is it, a lot.
Works. I'm sorry that you can't. But if you really want to see it,
it's a lot.
Then just
know that it's a lot. Now, then we do the happy music.
You don't have to be bad. You can be good. You can be.
Oh, no, son. Are you okay, son? Son, wake up. What have you done? You don't have to be bad. You don't have to be.
It goes back to sad music. Just because.
I have voices now.
Grim Reaper guy's back.
I just can't help it.
Really? Those aren't just shadow pigs? Hey.
And I was going to hang everybody under the bridge again, but then I realized I used the bridge this time, so that wouldn't really make sense.
It's true.
It's not a strange, mysterious place.
Yes.
So.
This is strange and mysterious.
Also, that's Play-Doh all around.
Very, very scary Play-Doh.
And then I got fake blood.
And then action returns.
Yeah.
And then it goes back to the sad music for the Legos falling.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it was the happy music again. So it goes back and forth. We for some reason, just kept playing with the music. Probably nobody noticed, but it's sad when he's talking to the guy. It's happy when he dies. It's sad when the other guy dies, and then it's happy at the
end. You can be.
No, son, are you okay, son? Son, wake up. What have you done? What have you done? You don't have to be bad. You don't have to be.
Sad.
I have voices now. What's that guy doing? Oh, he's just bad. Okay. Go on.
Happy music? That. Then sad music for the Legos falling.
Yeah. It really just turns around by the end.
Yep. Silly nonsense. Now, that's a fun one. Any more on that? We do have another one to get to, and we are at an hour and 40 minutes almost.
Yeah.
For 6 videos.
So if you have any fake super chats, don't forget to
like, share, and subscribe, folks.
Say in all caps fake super chat in the comments.
Tell them to like, share, and subscribe.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.
All right, I'm going to need to set up this new one. So give me 1 second and it'll look strange to you all. I'm sorry. I should have had this ready, but let me get this ready. Need that to be a different file, and that different file is this one.
Nobody
there can. It is. All right. Now, this is it. This is the moment that we've all been waiting for. Everybody has been waiting for.
This is the next step of phase season whatever two. Yeah.
So, any final thoughts on season one before we premiere the premiere of season two, boy?
I can't think while I'm playing piano.
Don't interrupt. I'm very focused.
This is great music. Do you use this in every podcast?
I do now.
Okay. So,
season one. We had the magic trick, the movie, the wrong way, and all the cartoons. Any final thoughts on season one before we move on to season two?
Yes.
For the big.
Season one sucked.
Who's trash? Who's trash? Do better. Try harder. Win.
That talking to the wrong person.
Oh.
You should be talking to Disney.
Send him in.
I will. Might be a little too late.
So no thoughts?
I have some thoughts.
Feel free to share them at any moment.
I feel like I've shared a lot of my thoughts.
Probably too many, but it's okay.
The stop motion video.
Do you have anything else that they need to know? Now's your time.
It's going to be a long time until you see me again. So, yeah.
Anything?
No, I actually don't. This video is great.
Any thoughts on the new one?
Next step to... I already said this. Season two, whatever. Yeah.
Set it up. Do you want to tell them what this is?
Should I explain the video?
Just give them a tease. What is it?
Bro and Joe.
The Adventures.
The Adventures of Bro and Joe. I really messed that up.
Which is what?
A video. G.I. Joe.
Come on, man!
Oh, my name is Bro. I'm a G.I. Joe.
Yes, there's a lot of outtakes from this one, too.
Yeah.
This will be it. This will be the first of some new stuff that we are working on. We already have another one. Well, after this one is done. This one is the first of season two. We have another one done that has nothing to do with this one. But there might be more to this one in the future. So, enjoy the premiere of... The Adventures of Bro and Joe, if I can find it.
The New Beginning.
The New Beginning.
Oh, that sounds so serious. You know, it's whatever, too.
The Fall. The Downfall.
Yeah.
Here we go.
What's your name, Private?
Bro, sup?
Bro? Private Bro? Seriously?
Yes, sir.
Well, I'm definitely not calling you Private Bro. What's your first name, maggot?
Cheesy Wig, sir.
Come again?
Cheesy Wig, sir.
Cheesy Wig? Yes. Cheesy Wig Bro is your name.
Yes.
I'm definitely not calling you Private Cheesy Wig. Are you kidding me? Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what your name is. While you're here, you are a maggot. Do you understand me? You are mine. You are my private. You are my private bro. No, wait. Never mind. Shut up. Let's go. So, tell me about yourself, bro.
Well, back in the third grade, what's this? Oh no!
What?
A quicksand pit! No!
What? No!
I'm dying!
No, bro! No!
I always knew
not
this
quicksand.
Day would come!
No, bro! No! No! Why? Why? Why quicksand? Why did it have to be quicksand? No! Bro! Bro, no, bro. No. No. Why? Bro. No.
I'm so glad you could make it in to see me today. It's been a while.
Yeah.
So what brings you in? How have you been feeling, Joanna?
It's Joe. Joe!
Right, sorry. Jeez. How have you been feeling? Joe.
Depressed. Scared. Alone, I guess.
Okay. Tell me more about that.
Well, I think it all goes back to my childhood.
Interesting. I wonder, could it have something to do with your childhood? Tell me more about your childhood.
Okay. I always saw it in the movies, in the TV shows. You just never think it could happen to you, you know? On the big screen, it's scary and all. But it's really something else when you see it up close. Like the Dukes of Hazzard, Batman, even I Love Lucy, the $6 Million Man, Tarzan, Fantasy Island, Gilligan's Island, The Fall Guy, The Bionic Woman, One Life to Live, Incredible Hulk, even The Princess Bride. The freaking Princess Bride! I saw it, I believed it, I knew it was real, but I still didn't think that it was real.
Yeah. What?
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 I saw it. I saw it. I believed it. But I did not think it was real.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Didn't think what was real?
Quicksand.
And I believe we will save the rest of the conversation for another time. Perhaps the recap and review of Season 2 coming soon to a platform near you. Boy, any final thoughts?
Yes,
anything
sir.
You'd like to say?
I mean...
Shut up, let's go.
We're bros.
We're not bros, bro.
Wait, no, that wasn't...
Never bro. Mind.
Talk about that next time.
Yes, another time, perhaps. For today, I think that'll be enough. Thank you for tuning in, and if you have nothing else to say, boy, we shall bid them adieu.
I do have something to say.
You do?
Yes, I do.
Not to do, you do.
Not to do, I do.
Well, do.
Yes, and do.
Do. Please do.
What? Once upon a time, there was a boy and his father. They set out to make a movie. In the end, they had six.
They had what?
They had six.
Six what?
Movies.
Six movies? They set out to make one movie, and they made six?
This is a dramatic moment.
Oh.
Goodbye.
Thank you all for tuning in. It's been a pleasure. I bid you good night and good luck. Go to smartshorts.com. I want to see. Now I'm curious. Goodbye, everybody.